Hi guys, my name is Juraj or George for English speaking people. I'm your 3D guru. In this video, I would like to share with you experience with original Prusa i3 Mark II 3D printer. I use this printer for 1 year and I have printed tens or maybe hundreds of models, mostly successful. However, there are few disadvantages and benefits that you should to know before buying your 3D printer, so let's look at it. As I have mentioned before, in the introduction, I have already printed a couple of models on this 3D printer, and during my 12 months of use, I had some good and bad experience. So I want to start with bad experience. At the beginning of assembly of 3D printer kit, the nut was unable to hold in the hole on the electronic box cover, which I temporarily closed with the cable tie, and later I printed the new box cover. After a couple days of use, I stopped liking the filament holder, which I later broke when I trying to change the filament spool. Many users of this 3D print, they have opinion that this filament holder is not completely practical because there are several different variants and more suitable versions of this holder on the internet. I printed one of them, but it still needs some improvements to make it usable. Another bad experience was that after a few months, an automatic calibration was stopped working with the error calibration Z-filet, sensor is disconnected or interrupted cable, white fluorescent. And when I tried XYZ calibration, I got the error calibration XYZ filet, look at the manual. I have received advice from Prusa Research Technical Support that I should to replace the induction probe because it probably had a broken cable. They offered me the new induction probe immediately for a few euros, however, I had a 3D printer still under warranty. I did not want to solve the warranty replacement of the induction probe because I need to use my 3D printer for printing, so I repaired 3D printer myself by finding a broken cable, as indicated by the email from Prusa Research. I reconnected this interrupted cable and made a modification of the wiring harness on the X-axis carriage. So I partially converted this 3D printer to a new version as the current version of Mark IIs already has. I prevented repetitive failure with this modification. At the same time, I have solved the problem of touching the extruder or X-carriage wiring with the printed model. This was also one of the problems that many users noticed. In the video description, you will find instruction for how to install parts for the newer version called Mark IIs. Later, at a personal meeting with Prusa research team at the Prague exhibition, they told me that some of these broken probes are under warranty and the new probe is changed for free. But why they did not write it down to the email from technical support? But much worse things happened. In the near future, I'm planning to finish the upgrade from Mark II to Mark IIs, and I will also make a video about this upgrade. Another disadvantage is the errors with very fast display menu button. Sometimes it happens that when I tune the button, I choose a completely different choice that I wanted, which sometimes does not really enjoying. For example, I choose a completely different object to print than I wanted. A disadvantage that can be assumed in this price category is detach the printed object from the heated bed or the warping of the printed model, mainly for ABS materials. If you need to print more complicated models larger than 10 cm, I centrally recommend to use a closed 3D printer. We can modify this 3D printer with a cover. Or you should use some other 3D printer that is designed for 3D printing with ABS material. The good experience are following. The 3D printer does not need to maintain very much. According to the recommendation of the manual, I have lubricated the axis with oil and after a few months I checked the nuts and screws. If they are tightened, I have prevented the screws from being unscrewed by this procedure and they can fall down directly on the print surface during printing. Also, I would like to say that this 3D printer can be easily expanded with the ability to watch and managing 3D printing via LAN or Wi-Fi directly from a mobile phone or tablet or PC. I will take a closer look at this topic in my next video, so watch me if you want to learn more about this. By the way, there are few other improvements for this 3D printer, such as lighting, cover and so on. With both of these improvements, we can meet in my next video, so be sure to subscribe to my channel. Another good experience is that the preparation of the 3D printing on the PC is also much more easier thanks to Prusa control software directly from Prusa Research, which is fairly easy to understand even for new users. I would like to make a compliment to Mr. Prusa's team for the simply using of this great 3D printer. Of course, for more complicated prints, you need to reach the already known Slicer or Slice3R software. The advantage is that even if the surface of the heating bed is damaged, especially if the prints are taken using a palette knife or a scraper, but I have a spare part self-adhesive PEI foil, which the user can replace himself. Of course, you can purchase a spare part of PEI foil at Prusa Research Shop. Overall, I can compliment this 3D printer and also recommend it to beginner users. Currently marketed Mark IIS version already has some bugs fixed. However, let's take a closer look at buying new 3D printers in my next video, so be sure to subscribe to my channel so you will not miss my new videos in the future. So, if you are not a regular YouTube watcher and you want to receive notification about every new video, just click on the small bell button to send a notification about my new videos on your email. Thank you for watching this video and look forward to see you on my next video. I wish you all the best. Bye bye.